Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can create a bloom effect on Spline. As you can see here, when I rotate, the bloom effect kind of like affects the bright colors and makes this really nice glow over the bright colors that it also has the same color of the material. Alright, let's begin. Okay, so for this scene, the first thing will be to delete this object because we don't need it. I also want a different background, maybe something like this. Here I just want to create some spheres, so I'm going to start creating some sphere here, someone here, maybe another one here, and perhaps another one here, and another here, and another here. So I just want to create several spheres because those are the ones who are going to be glowing. And then I want to move some of those spheres in the space, so it feels a little better. I can disable my grip, I don't need that. So I'm going to select all of these objects and I want to create an asset for them. So this is gonna be called, let's say, the base color. So the base color is gonna be actually like a dark color. I think something like that should work. And we want this to be without shininess. So this is gonna be like a flat color. Let's delete this light for now. And for this object here, I want to detach the asset, and now let's change the color here to be a little different. So I want this to be an overlay, and I want this to be a bright color, perhaps a little blue, something like that. And then for the other objects here, I want to do something similar. But before that, let's create a new light here. It's gonna be a point light. And let's put it right in the same position of the bright sphere, and then let's move it there so it fits more or less the same position. Let's also change the color of that light to be something like slightly bluish. I think that would be better. Something like that should work. So what I want now is that I want some of these other spheres to have like a different color. So these two could be maybe like a violet color, so we can use overlay here. Could be something like this. These two could be something like a cyan color, so let's use overlay. And maybe this could be a little bit more like pink. Yeah, so let's make this into an asset. So this is gonna be pink, and this is gonna be cyan. Okay, so what I want to do now is that I want to add an overlay to the sphere. So let me start by the base. So I'm going to add a new outline layer here, and then I'm going to change the color to white, and then let's change the blending mode to overlay. So yeah, that's looking good. Now let's do the same with the pink. New outline layer, put it white, and then let's use overlay. And then finally for the cyan, new outline layer, let's call it white, and let's use overlay. Alright, so now that our scene is in a good shape, we just need to enable the bloom. So I'm going to go here to the post-processing effects, and I'm going to toggle on, and then we want to enable the bloom, so I'm going to click on this icon here to enable bloom. You can see that by default it's adding this little bloom effect, but it's maybe too subtle for what we're looking for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click here in the gear icon, and then I'm going to change the kernel size to be huge. So this works better. We can change a little the intensity if we want to. I think for now this actual intensity is pretty nice, but we can play around with the threshold. You can see if I change the threshold, it's actually removing some of the other intensities there. But then again, I think the default threshold is cool. And finally, the smoothing is just smoothing out the general glow of this, but let's just use the default. If you go to a play mode here, we can see how it looks, and it's kind of nice, but I feel like maybe we can enable the aberration effect. So this is just adding like a chromatic aberration, and you can see that it's very nice when we have this effect because it's kind of like blurring the light a little bit. All right, that is it. That's how you can add bloom effects to your objects on Spline. I hope you like this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.